Hey, it's Dan Z from Coffee with Kenobi bringing you today's CWK Coffee Break, Anakin Skywalker. When you hear that name, what goes through your mind? It's a mixed bag, I realize, but to me, Anakin Skywalker is a tragic hero in the persona of a Shakespearean tragic hero, like a Hamlet, because it's this person that comes from a high place of stature in their culture, in their society, and then because of their one tragic flaw, the fall from grace proves to be fatal. We know that happens with Anakin. And I really saw it come to life recently when I was showing my mythology students episodes 1, 2, and 3 in about a week, week and a half time span. Those prequels are a little bit longer than the original trilogy, and it shows when you're trying to show it in a high school classroom setting. But we made it through, and it was incredible fun, especially because of their emotional reactions to Anakin. Episode 1, of course, he's that little boy who's amazing in the pod race, and he's charming, and you know there's something good and special about him. Episode 2, Anakin is 10 years older. He's a very powerful Jedi, more powerful than he realizes. He's got pride, which of course is not a great thing. Thematically, we know pride comes before the fall, but he struggles with that, of course. And he's arrogant, but he also wants to be good. He wants to do right. And then he gets put in this terrible situation where his mother is dying and dies in his arms. And then we know how that impacted him. He says to Padme he killed the sand people and the women and the children. Ouch. Terrible, terrible, terrible. And then when he tells Padme, there's that crescendo of Darth Vader's Imperial March. And you know the seeds are there, and this was like a main thing, a major thing in his evolution. Revenge of the Sith, which you could spend an entire month of CWK Coffee Breaks on, is a beautiful movie. The way it's filmed, the lighting, the acting with Anakin and Emperor Palpatine, Chancellor Palpatine together is unforgettable. The way that Palpatine manipulates Anakin is just something, I mean, it's a thing of beauty to watch the way they execute on film. And that is why, that's one of many reasons why, say what you will about George Lucas, the man is a genius. And Revenge of the Sith proves that. All the things that he had to deal with, all the criticism, which some are fair, some are not as fair, he made an excellent Godfather-type movie with this power of this amazing character's fall from grace. It is really, really well done. I realize the movie came out in 2005. This isn't a review. This is more of a, hey, you need to give Revenge of the Sith and Anakin Skywalker another chance, because the power of his fall from grace is real. You can see him conflicted. It's a masterwork. Thank you for joining me for today's CWK Star Wars Thought for the Day on our CWK Coffee Break. Thanks for spending your coffee break with me. We'll see you next time.